I've tried a lot of paid tools over my years as a content creator, and this one that I use every single week is not only free, but it's extremely user-friendly and easy to learn. I'm talking about iMovie. Today, I'm going to share a complete tutorial of how I edit my YouTube content in iMovie so that you can replicate the process for your video content as well. Hey there, everyone. Welcome back to my channel, or welcome if you're new here. My name is Austin, and I am a fashion and beauty content creator based in New York City. I use this channel to help micro-influencers create great content, grow their digital brands, and generate sustainable income from content creation. So, if any of that interests you, please do consider subscribing to my channel for new videos every Tuesday. Now, I'll admit, I have been tempted over the years by a little Final Cut there, a little Adobe Premiere there, but at the end of the day, iMovie just checks all of the boxes for me. It's easy to use, it's generally reliable, and after almost 5 years of editing about one video a week for my YouTube channel, I've definitely got a system down now that makes it even more easy and streamlined. So let me share my screen and we'll jump right into this tutorial.
Okay, so here we are in iMovie, and the first thing that I did just to make sure that I keep this video moving is I dragged in the three clips that I'm going to use in this video. The first one is just me posing for the thumbnail, and then I dragged these two main clips of me talking down into the editor. To import these clips, I first put my camera clips on this hard drive. I really like it. It's a Toshiba 2 TB hard drive. I'll link it in the description box down below in case you also need a hard drive for your video content. And I'm also in the process of backing my videos up to Google Cloud. But this is what it looks like at the beginning of editing. And you can zoom in or zoom out. Oh, I didn't even drag the second clip in. Whoops. Which is good that I was able to zoom out and see that to just make sure that you have a good bird's eye view of what your video looks like. So before I even start editing, the first thing I do is select all of the clips. So I'm going to do Command A on my Mac and click on this up here. So this is going to reduce the background noise of my clips, which I sometimes need to make sure that the audio is the best it can be. So I'll usually turn this on and bring it up to 70%. Now, before I start going in and editing moment by moment, first I do a scan of the video and I look for any big gaps in audio. So you can see the audio here and you can see that there is a gap. So I'm going to right click and do split clip. You can also do Command B, whatever's easiest, and then split it where I know that it still is being silent, and then delete those clips first. And this is going to help give me a rough cut of this video so that I don't have to worry too much about those unnecessary silences, and it also makes the total time of the recording go down. So now I'm going to go in and make individual cuts for the clips that I want to keep. Oftentimes I'll repeat myself a few different times, so I probably won't be just cutting out the silences within these 26 minutes. It'll probably be even shorter than that because sometimes I repeat a few things. The dog that lives next door to me was barking a little bit too, so sometimes I had to repeat things because of that. But I'll generally go in and I'll right click and do split clip, or you can do Command B, and I will try to get the clip right at the beginning and right at the end as close as possible because I like my videos to be snappy without too much lag. So that's how I typically edit. So I will split that clip here. Then I stop talking, so then I will split there. And this was a bad first take because I heard the dog barking, so I'm just going to delete that. And again, my computer's lagging a little, unfortunately, just because I have two programs going at once and it's a little slow, but I will basically repeat this process throughout the video until I get a rough cut of what I'm looking for. So I'm going to fast forward through me going through all of these clips and getting a rough cut of this video. Now, one thing I do a lot in my videos, which is a really simple but effective editing technique, is I'll sometimes zoom in on myself on important points or words for emphasis or little jokes or asides just to add a bit of visual diversity to my videos. So I was talking about my lip color in this, and this is what I said.
If I recommend my Fenty lip product, which I do, by the way, it's great.
Okay, so I want to separate, which I do, by the way, it's great. So let's go here. So I'm going to cut right there, and I'm going to cut there. And then I'm going to go up to this tool here, crop to fill. And I'm just going to shrink down the screen a little bit and center it. Here's what it looks like.
If I recommend my Fenty lip product, which I do, by the way, it's great.
Now that's what that looks like. And that just made the video a little bit more engaging. And maybe if you looked away, but you saw movement and you saw it zoom in a bit, you might pay closer attention to it. So yeah, that is a little editing trick. I'm gonna finish doing a rough cut of this video and then we will get into adding some more fun stuff in. And as I'm editing, I also have the Notes app open and I'm making note of some timestamps and some things that I might want to mention or add in to my video. So I have a few things that I want to overlay with an image or with something else, and I'm just putting little timestamps here of when I encounter those so that I know where to put them in when I go to add those little overlays later. All right, we did it. So I now have a rough cut of my video that's coming in at 15 minutes and 29 seconds, much shorter than me just rambling, which is great. And the next thing I'm going to do is drag in pretty much everything that I usually include in my YouTube videos. So I have this YouTube folder here, and I have a folder within here called Assets. So I'm going to drag all of these things into iMovie. And they're gonna load in, and you can see what they are in here. So I have a little phone overlay of my Instagram. I have the influencer launchpad, which I usually mention in most videos. This is the song that I use. This is my little intro screen. This is my Instagram handle. This is my end screen template, and this is a little ping noise. You guys are probably familiar with that. And then, of course, my subscribe and like animations. So what I usually do is have a little intro of a few different clips where I explain what I'm going to talk about in the video, and then I will add my intro. Okay, so this is where I'm going to drag this clip. It goes right in between here. And if I want the clip to be silent, I would lower the audio, but Gabby, who designed this for me, made it silent to start with, so I don't even have to worry about that. But then this little 5 second clip plays. It says my channel name, it has a little subscribe button, and then I start talking. So the next thing I'm going to add in is my handle. Okay, so this is not going to take up the whole screen, but when I first drag it over here, that's what it's going to look like. So I'm going to go up to this drop-down menu and select picture in picture. Looks good, but why is it cropped? One of the little special things about iMovie, you're going to go over to this crop tool and make sure it just says fit instead of crop to fill. And now you can see my username in full. So I'm going to drag this to the bottom left-hand corner of the screen. I'm going to make it a tiny bit bigger. And I'm also going to turn off dissolve. I like when things just pop on versus fade in, especially when they're these little animations. And it automatically sets to 8 seconds, but I can make that a little bit shorter if I don't want it on the screen for that long. Also, with this is where I go drag my little ping. This is actually the noise of a champagne cork, apparently, but I like what it sounds like. I'm just picturing me like popping bottles while I'm filming this. Okay, so then I drag it right under the clip. So it's really snappy. It pops up, the sound matches, and it has a good effect to it. I really think timing is one of the biggest things in iMovie, especially because there aren't any other like super special or crazy effects that I typically do in my videos. So the timing of this does matter to me. About to say subscribe, so I'm going to do the same thing with this little animation. And I just bought this animation on Etsy. I'll leave a link to it in the description box because it is so cute and fun. So this bothers me less for some reason when it dissolves in, so I'm not going to change the dissolve. I'm going to have it as picture in picture and then drag it down here. And I am going to put the same noise with it again just to get someone's attention back on the screen and really hope and drive home the point that I would like them to subscribe. So now this is where I would normally go through the video, pull up my notes list, and I also made note of what I wanted to make sure I was linking in the description box, like things that I mentioned in the video that I don't want to forget to link to. And I want to go through and put in either photos or video overlays of these things so that people can see what I was talking about and to add a little bit more interest to the video. And these things are all video specific. The assets that I dragged over before are things that are pretty much in every single video. So I'm going to go build some of these and then I will come back and show you the same drag and drop process of how I apply them in. And for a lot of these, I'll usually either just use that picture-in-picture effect I showed you, or I might also create a graphic in Canva, download it with a transparent background, and use that as an overlay too. Okay, so I've gone ahead and dragged and dropped in a few more elements that I'm going to want to include in this video, and I'm going to basically watch through the rest of the video and then pay attention to my timestamps and drop in any of the little overlays that I want to add in. I do recommend watching through the video again one more time as you're editing, just to make sure there aren't any little adjustments that you might want to make or sections you might want to cut out. I already have a section of this video that I kind of feel like isn't really adding much value to it, so I think I'm going to delete that and just make sure that it all looks and sounds good. So I'm going to fast forward through what some of that looks like, but first I'm going to show you just an example of me dragging and dropping in an overlay. So around the 357 timestamp, I mentioned that I have other videos about pitching and reaching out to brands. I found it, and it's about a minute later because I forgot I accidentally cut out a minute of my video at the beginning. So I'll estimate that all my timestamps are a minute after when I thought they were, and drag in this clip, which as you can see will be transparent. Okay, so I want that to come more like here. And again, it is auto doing the Ken Burns thing. So I'm just going to put fit on the screen and that should just pop up. And I will also add my little sound effect here just for emphasis. And I'm going to drag this clip to last until I cut the clip. And I also have to remember to link those videos. Okay, now I will fast forward through rewatching through the video and adding more of my timestamps. Okay, and so I've gone through and watched the video. I did cut one section that I didn't really think was adding value. I'm just gonna make the timeline a little smaller. And I did go in and overlay everything that I wanted to while I was talking. So now I am at the end over here. I'm going to drag over my end screen and I have a template for this in Canva, so I just drag in and fill these two videos versus this end screen down here. This is actually what the Canva template looks like. And either they are up already or they are going up very soon on my Patreon community. I did actually make a few YouTube end screen templates. So my Patreon community is always linked in the description box if you wanted to check it out and get access to those templates. If they're not live right now, they should be very soon. So keep an eye out for those. And now I'm done with the bulk of the video. And so the very last thing that I do is add my music. So I use Epidemic Sound to get my music because it is copyright free music, and it's definitely better than some of the free music in my opinion. So here's the song that I use, and I only place it in two parts. I'm gonna show you. So I'm gonna drag it down to underneath here. My face is in the way, but if you can see it down here, this is actually a separate bar where you can place music in iMovie. So that might be very loud. So the first thing that I do is turn down the volume to 50%. Make sure it's aligned with when the intro starts. This is what it looks like. Okay, so then I'm going to cut the song right here. But then what I'm going to do is cut it again, like less than 1 second into the video here. I'm going to move this out of the way for just a second. And then I'm going to make the volume like 3 or 4%. So again, let's make this even a little bit quieter, like 50%. So it's not like choppy. It kind of fades out a little bit more. So that's just one kind of trick I've learned. We're actually going to drag the song to the end of the video. I'm like pointing at the end of the video and do the opposite there. So I'm going to drag this. So now at the end, what I'm going to do is have the music playing at a low volume as I'm doing my outro and then raise the volume when my end card appears. So let me show you what that will look like. Usually I'll have the song kind of start as I'm doing my outro, maybe have 30 seconds of it or less at a really low volume. And then when I say goodbye, it should get louder. And then I'm going to make one last cut here. Split clip, delete the rest of that song. Make sure it's dragged all the way to the end. Ooh, not past the end. And we're done. So next thing I'll do is export to my external hard drive. So I'm gonna plug this in. And then I will upload to my YouTube channel, and that's how I edit my videos on iMovie.
All right, and that just about wraps up this video on iMovie. Thank you guys so much for watching. If you do have any questions that maybe I didn't get to address in this video or anything you want me to clarify, leave me a comment down below. I'll do my best to read and reply to as many of them as possible. And if you are looking for additional resources as a content creator, I have things like my free guide, the Influencer Launchpad, that you can download. And I also have a bunch of different playlists here on my YouTube channel. I'll link some in the description box that I think will be of interest to you if you liked this video. Please do consider subscribing to my channel if you're not already. I would love to have you as a subscriber if you're interested in all things content creation and influencer marketing. I do upload new videos every Tuesday, but you can actually also turn on the notification bell so that you never miss a video from me and you get notified right when I upload. And last but not least, if you enjoyed this and it helped you, please do give me a thumbs up down below. That really helps my channel out and lets me know what type of content you guys are enjoying the most. I'll be back again next week with another new video. Until then, thanks again for watching and have an amazing rest of your day. Bye.